Friday Night Pints is brought to you by Revitalite. You're going to need Revitalite this weekend, every weekend of the summer. Final part, you're going to the beach, you're getting drunk every single weekend, right?
Me? Never.
Every single night.
No, I don't do that.
And you need to bounce back. You need that Revitalite. It helps you cure your hangovers. Also, even if you don't drink, you need electrolytes, you need to hydrate, you want a nice, flavorful drink, why don't you get the one that partnered up with Barstool Sports for the Black Label? Anytime you call something Black Label, instantly classy. So the Revitalite Black Label is here from Barstool Sports. It's a blue flavor, which is the most important flavor. Anytime you're doing any of these drinks, blue is the best. Black Label's the
most
best
hydrating.
Name. Most hydrating. The only way to
do
it.
Whoa!
How cool was that?
I feel like I'm a cocktail right now.
It's already down like 70% of it.
Well, that's what you do, by the way. You drink it before you go out, and then you drink it. I think you drink it during. I think if you have a drink with it as your mixer, you drink it during the night, and you stay hydrated, Kevin, and then and then the next day, if you do have a little bit of hangover, you finish off that bottle, you're good to go. You can get it at the Barstool Sports store. You can also get it at Drink Revitalite, so you don't have to go to the baby aisle of the CVS anymore. Drink Revitalite, get that Black Label, stay hydrated, stay healthy. Publicity, first time on the show, right?
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Welcome. We were just talking, and you, everyone's been on. Big Daddy making kind of your return. You were our norm for a while, and then you got too cool.
That's
and you're not
true.
Been on the show.
That's not true.
I don't know, like 3 months.
That's not true. Although I know I look tan right now.
You do?
A lot of compliments.
So tan.
Thank you. That's what I do it for, because Glennie does the same thing.
I think he's more of a sunburn.
Glennie,
it's going to turn. Don't worry. Glennie's favorite thing in the world is coming back after a weekend and people complimenting his tan.
Yes.
And now I know what that feels
like. Well, the reason Feidelberg said that is because he came back looking like a bright red tomato. Like, it's a tan, Trent.
It was a tan.
It was so red.
I get it. It's really
you're very tan.
Yeah, you got a great tan.
I didn't think you'd be the olive tone type.
I don't think I've ever seen you tan.
My
you've
skin,
been golfing for a while, but have you ever been tan in your life?
It's pretty rare, but my skin, when it happens, when I actually see the sun, things happen.
Are you, will you burn if you don't cover up, or like you can just let it rip?
The first time out, I'll burn like everybody else, but then once I get this type of base, I'm good.
People are surprised. I'm kind of that way, too. My family is, like, Irish. Like, the sun, like, we are allergic to it, and it's like we're vampires. You step out, we burn. But not me. Like, I mean, I'm still pretty white, so I got to manage it, but not as much as you think. I can go out there and, like, not put much on, and I'm okay.
Yeah, we went golfing the other day, and Frankie is, like, taking a bath.
Frankie's legit translucent.
Right, yeah, I got to hold an umbrella over him. But I go out now, and, like, I just...
Michael Jackson.
What was Diddy's guy's name? What was his name?
Fonzworth Bentley.
Fonzworth Bentley. I love that guy.
Dude, I read an article about him just, like, a couple weeks ago. He's still out there doing it.
Holding umbrellas?
Wait,
that
was Diddy's guy? I thought he's the guy from Hey Ya, right?
I think, he went on
Wait,
to do more, but
Hey
Ya, he was like, Diddy's like...
Are you thinking about Andre 2000?
No. He's in the
boy.
He's in the Hey Ya video, right?
He just became like a rap guy, but he was like Diddy's like butler.
Like actual butler?
Maybe. I don't think so. I don't know.
I actually don't know the origin story.
I think it was almost like, Frankie being like Dave's guy. It was like Fonzworth's Diddy's guy.
Yeah.
But then I think he got his own star a little bit. And I think he started selling... like bow ties and suspenders.
Yeah.
That was his thing.
So he's like the Jonathan Sheban of like...
That one.
Same thing. I was like, I hope it wasn't the only one.
Friend,
holy shit.
Best friend.
Food God guy?
Yeah. Oh, Food God. Okay.
For being the best friend of Food God.
He's been around, so
yeah.
I'll just refrain from... You guys like him? You like him?
I hear he blocks a lot of people on social media.
Oh, and I don't like that. Can't block people. I think he looks like the Scarecrow from The Wizard of Oz.
But you know what I mean? Like, you get your star power from,
from
the star.
From the person.
And now
right.
they have their own, like, ventures.
Which is, like, to me, the ultimate sign of when you're the star. Like when Chris Rock was talking about Monica Lewinsky. Like, Bill Clinton is so famous. She sucked his dick and she became famous.
Yes.
Right. That is...
Residual stardom,
essentially.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bottom line, I'm tan and I look awesome.
The moral of the story.
That's really
just
what it is.
You look awesome,
Trent. Thank you. I appreciate that.
I can't wait for, like... this to go to Trent's head. Imagine Trent being like, imagine like hot guy Trent.
I'd love to become
imagine
a
Imagine, I'm looking at it.
I'd really love to do a full 180.
Well, it's perfect that you, we were just talking about the BBL. Do you know what that is, if I say BBL?
No.
Brazilian butt lift.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're scary.
Is like what we've all come to learn in the last couple years, but even I feel like just like this year, majorly.
TikTok is
a big source of it for sure, yeah.
Everybody has a fake ass. The BBL is the process is taking fat out of somewhere else and you put it into your ass.
Okay.
And like, everybody does it. So,
just if you're a common girl on TikTok, regular ass flying to Miami to get it.
It says like they like TikTok exposes like the celebrities.
No, they're
exposing
themselves.
No, they're doing it to like themselves.
They're like 2 days to my BBL, one day to another, like showing the results.
Does it look awesome?
But no, some of them, like, they look perfectly normal. Like usually when you think about it, you think that they're putting out these like huge asses, but these girls are just taking like a tiny bit of fat
and
just making it look like it would be a normal.
I like the subtlety of it. Though.
Yes, like so it all depends on like who you are. Like Asa Akira got fake tits, but she got like a big beat. You know what I mean? She was like, I'm not going to walk around like fucking ridiculous, but she was like, I just got nicer tits.
I never knew she had fake boobs until she said it.
Right? That's kind of like the way you want it, right?
Right.
I mean, she's open about it, so she's like, whatever, I don't care. But if you wanted to make people think that they're real, you just like go not so big.
Sure.
And I think girls that are smart and like the famous people who have the right team and publicists or whatever do like, just a little bit.
What?
I mean, you got the idiots who walk around with a fucking dong.
You realize everyone has it. In Hollywood.
I guess it also depends on how much fat you have elsewhere to put in, right?
Yeah,
it's like,
true.
Listen, girl, we can't make
it
much
bigger. They gotta have reserves in the back.
But I don't think you can put, like, you know,
from the liposuctions? Like, I mean, come on.
They, like, just get, like, a bucket of lard, and they're just like, what?
But is it,
like, in fucking Fight Club, when they make all the fucking soap, it's just like, just fucking
whale blubber and shit.
I think that you become
a puker too, hanging out too much with him.
Because people get like just get liposuction, right?
Have you ever seen that?
What are they putting on?
That's what they do.
Did they just freeze it?
Yeah, what's wrong? Just keep it in the back in the fridge.
It can't be like it's a blood type where it's like one matches the other.
I would imagine your own fat is.
Don't people get like shots, like ass injections?
Well, that's what I thought this was. So what?
Because
they I think slice open.
Filler's
and then,
filler's the one that goes. Like you were talking about how it can like.
Filler's when people's faces look
filler. Yeah, so like filler you can get in your ass, that'll go away.
Same thing you put in your lips and shit, or different type of stuff.
I think it's the same.
Oh, it is.
I don't know.
Are people like dying from the fillers in their ass though?
Well, yeah, but that's like when they put cement in.
Yeah. People are getting. Man, have you seen some of the botched? The asses on botched are fucking. There was this chick on. I love Botched. Botched is one of my guilty pleasures.
Really?
So those little fucking those little doctors, the little gnomes.
I miss Nip Tuck too. What a great show.
There was this one girl who had a comically huge ass, and they could flip her thing.
Yeah, I've seen that.
It was like flat. It was like a dome.
It looks almost like a milk dud that's like in their ass, and like they're shifting it around, or like a dot.
So you could put the round side in and the flat side out.
So the flat side is facing out.
People do that with their boob implants.
Yeah.
Like move them.
Could she could flip it herself?
They probably did it, but I think
because that's probably pretty nice. Like if you're sitting down,
right? What if you're hooking up with a girl and you're flipping her ass and it flips?
Like you flip the ass and then
flip it. Yeah, if you have a cross country flight, you just flip that thing.
Like flipping your pillow at night.
Oh, that sounds better.
Yeah.
It's a little colder.
What if you were like having sex from behind and they just start to flip and then like that would be
so
fucking weird?
With the fake asses.
Seems like another positive.
I think, you know, fake tits are. I'm not a real. I don't like fake tits, but you get them if you get a good one.
Careful, Kevin.
And they look nice. You're good, right? But I also feel like you know they don't feel as good, right? But there's not as much going on with your tits, like your ass, like. It's involved in sex and grabbing and touching and hitting and smashing and all that. And if it's
smashing?
Hey, you go in the world.
She has a bag? What are you doing?
Here we come.
What the fuck?
When Kevin has sex, it's like a fucking cartoon mouse.
He's in the great part.
Smack.
Like fucking Gallagher in the bedroom.
Like, it looks nice, your tits, but if your ass is like doesn't feel right, that, to me, I'd rather be like a smaller...
But I think
these
ones that they're getting in Hollywood don't feel anyway because it's not an implant.
That's the thing. That's why the fat is good.
Yeah.
I just, if I was a chick, and I learned this now, any normal girl you see that has a great ass, like round of applause. Because everyone else is cheating.
Right.
It's like the baseball player in the 90s who did it legit.
Right, it's like Pedro pitching.
My biggest question is,
it's Ken Griffey Jr. It's,
where are people getting the money from to do this? Like, I don't
What's
get
it run yet?
Because
I'm,
you know, I don't know. I'm assuming it's 10K.
Okay. Well, I think anything. Wow,
you thinking about it?
No, but it's like
I think I'd love to be a guy with a fucking sexy ass.
Would you get?
I think I'd like to be known as a hot
ass.
Yeah,
it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Would you get like a comically large one, or would you try to do?
No, I just get a top one.
So,
but you see, the problem is you don't end up looking
no ass.
A baseball ass.
Looks like I've been doing fucking a bunch of squats and stuff.
Yeah. I think it's like you don't want to end up looking like an AirPod, basically, like where it's like you have skinny leg and then just like a giant fat ass. It makes no sense. You want like a thick thigh going into the big ass.
Well, then we start with the quads. We work our way up.
Yeah. Exactly. See.
Right. Then the worry is that like you sort of lose touch with the reality and you become one of those people who just you can't stop.
How does that happen? Yeah.
I don't know. It happens a lot.
That really is.
Do men have insecurities about like their calves being too thin or something?
There are many people who have big insecurities.
Right. And then you just
have insecurities about everything.
Right. But like we don't have the impulse to then like start injecting our stuff, right. And then it just you turn into like the Michelin Man.
Yeah, I think you do. It is like a mental illness when you see those people who want to turn into the Ken doll or look like Justin Bieber or whatever.
You've seen the Russian guy, right, with like the synthol biceps,
where it's
just like all the way out to here, but then his forearms like my size.
I want to know what he sees in the mirror.
Right.
Yeah,
he must see like that. He's like that's it.
Yeah. He is like the opposite of body dysmorphia.
Yeah,
he thinks it looks really good.
I think sometimes I think body dysmorphia is fake and it's something that we made up for ugly people to rely upon. No, that's not what other people see.
Can you explain what body dysmorphia is? Like, is it, you think you look worse or you think you look better?
I think it's both.
Okay. It can go both ways. Okay.
I think it just means you don't see what you look like.
But if you look better, that'd be a great disease to have.
That's like
walking around like this.
That's like called illusion.
What's that movie called with Amy Schumer?
Oh, yeah, what's that movie?
I Feel Pretty, I think it is.
Yeah.
Where she just walks around with like a ton of confidence because it's like a reverse Shallow
Hal. Or the OG one.
Shallow Hal?
Yeah.
Yeah. So like that.
Gwyneth Paltrow.
Which is, you know, that's how we should all be. We should all walk around like we're there. Because I mean, guys can do that. Guys, I think the reason why guys don't go down that road is because we get by on our personalities. You know, it's like
you're held to a different standard.
Well, that definitely is true. But also, at the end of the day, it's like I can have ugly calves and all that shit, but the calves weren't the reason I'm gonna hook up with that girl anyway.
Yeah.
She's gonna like my jokes or hopefully, you know, like my personality because you guys are dumb and you don't like how we look. It's crazy. I don't know. No, thank God you don't. But so we don't have to do that. But the BBL is just.
I have a question.
And by the way,
I think
it ranges from 3 to 30K.
3 to 30?
So I promise you a 3K.
3K will
get it.
You can talk
I'll
about
do a few Instagram posts. I'll get that to 1,500 quick.
We should
get down with a plastic surgeon.
Uh-huh.
And do it.
Bro,
remember?
I don't have one on my podcast. No, an ad. Yeah. Like the guy from Botched. And
yeah,
ask them about
sure.
Shit.
Remember when the fucking plastic surgeon wanted to do our dicks?
Yeah, we almost
what?
Had one.
What? Yeah.
What was he going to do to him, though?
Just suck it.
What did he want to do with your dicks?
He wanted to,
obviously, make them larger.
Electrocute them,
yes.
What?
The way that,
for what reason?
To enlarge them.
No, it wasn't enlarging. It was blood flow, and it was like, it's like you'll have taken Viagra for the rest of your life.
Oh, they do that with women. They inject blood into your clit to have better orgasms.
Huh.
I know all this weird shit.
I hope we have a solo.
They do that to women.
Who cares about girls and girls' orgasms anyway?
Let's get back to the dick.
Was somebody talking over there?
Dude, I remember taking the phone call with the
assistant. Yeah, we went down that road a little too far.
I was in until he was like, so we just strap it up to this electrolysis machine. And I was like, to a what? And he's like, and we just send like electrode charge through your dick for a half hour. And I was like, bro, you're going to kill me.
That to me.
But also, I feel like that was on the early end of that science. That was 4 years ago.
Also, when you hear laser and electric and all that stuff, you know, we're thinking, guys, fucking lightning bolts, and that's not the case. But we were early enough that we was like, we're guinea pigs, and you're gonna break our dicks.
Well, think about it. People get LASIK. That's like your laser
in your
eyeball.
Yeah, but worst thing that happens there is you just go blind.
Yeah.
Worst thing that happens with your dick is it stops
significantly
working.
Worse.
Well, that's a good question. Would you rather go blind or
blind or dickless? That's literally a question.
Oh yeah, that is literally a question. And I think I usually say like, you know, you think about it. Yeah, that sucks to not have a dick.
Yeah.
But it affects. You know, you have sex a few minutes at a time. Few hundred thousand times a life. So you add it all up, it's not that much time of your life. Every single second being blind, your life sucks.
I'd probably have to go.
I just want to be a freak with no dick. I'd rather be like, just I can't have sex ever again.
Yeah.
But
they just chemically castrated me accidentally. That's fine.
Right. But even the, Game of Thrones is so far in the past, I can't remember anybody's name.
Reek.
No, well, him. The one who dates Miss Andy. Is that what you're talking about?
No,
he's one of the Unsullied.
Oh, yeah.
They just cuddle, which is still fine, I think.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he makes the best of it. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, at least he can see color. I mean, if I don't have a dick, yeah, I mean, that's kind of the next best thing.
You like to be
and you can do other stuff, too.
Can do other stuff?
Yeah, like, yeah, you don't need a dick to do a little fucking pussy and a little finger.
Well, yeah, you just become the ultimate giver.
Yeah, but I mean, eventually you want.
You want that?
I did. Like,
what if you're? I'm gonna give you the choice between a boyfriend with a dick.
Okay.
He is dick full.
Okay.
He is dick full.
All right.
But like,
pretty
it doesn't work
these days.
It just doesn't work
at all.
Like, he never gets hard.
Okay.
But he's not like known as like this dickless freak. or you have a guy who has no dick, but he is like. Bangarang with the mouth and the hands and everything else.
I don't know.
Well, if the dick doesn't work, then what's the point?
I think it's more of an optics thing, though.
Yeah, like he's not gonna be.
Oh, I don't care about that. Like, he's gonna wear pants. Like, it's not like he has to walk around with another fucking dick.
Also,
right?
He has to dress like Winnie the Pooh
all the time, every day.
If you lose your dick, you don't lose. Like, when you lose your balls, that's when the castration takes effect, right? Like, that's how you lose the testosterone and all that shit. Mm-hmm. But if you lose just the shaft.
If you're shaft and just balls, that's
just. Imagine if you just had balls.
That's hideous.
Imagine if you just had balls.
It's like the grossest image I've ever heard.
I don't want that.
Just balls?
That'd be so funny.
You
want
to see it.
If you could just do like the fucking, like a swing. just ride your bike.
You look like fucking truck nuts. Like, you literally got on the back of a car. That'd be so gross.
I'm so sorry. This is your first appearance. Yeah. She can handle it, but this is tough.
Well, actually, my friend works with old people, and she told me that their dicks shrivel up, my friend.
Old
and then they just have balls.
Old people.
Really?
So you
they
have
got
a lot to
balls
look
forward
to. So she said old men get inverted dicks and just have balls.
What? Just a
fucking bigger balls too.
She sees it.
Like, that's something to live for.
We're all like taking
balls. It's coming your way.
Oh,
yeah.
So. That was great. I was like, sometimes I like push my dick in, and he goes like, ah, and I was like, or I pull my balls over. He goes, oh well, yeah.
Obviously. Dude, that's the best.
Come on. When it's hot out, that you can do anything with that dick.
I feel like guys, you guys aren't like playing with your pussies, do you?
No.
There's nothing to play with.
Like
about.
In a non-sexual way.
I mean, yeah, in a non-sexual
so
way,
like,
no. Like you guys will just like...
Because we don't have to like move it in our pants. Like, you guys are always arranging.
Yeah.
Well, there's a lot, you know, it's
a lot of adjusting, arranging, and like you're saying, like drape the balls over the dick, like that helps it. That's the best.
Yeah, no, we're not that sitting thing. At home.
Dude, yeah, that's great. Right.
Yeah, armadillo.
It's amazing.
Draped it over.
Yeah, like all the time. You would not believe.
Yeah.
Just get bored, you know.
Like, I almost want to. Yesterday we had Rudy on. This is just a continuation of Cancer Radio. We were talking lots of like Jackie actually tweeted it. Jackie's probably gonna sue us for like sexual harassment soon enough. Jackie, our producer, made
that's his thing. Don't walk over the cameras. That's his thing.
Jackie tweeted out her producer notes and she said, "All I'm gonna say is that this is tomorrow's episode." Description: Rudy joins us for the first part of the show where the guys discuss 1. Fast food boners, 2. Pre-nap boners, 3. Airplane boners, 4. Curved dicks, 5. Stuffing your balls back into yourself.
Yeah.
6. Farting out your own balls. 7. And finally, 7. Post-nut clarity after you suck your own dick.
Yeah, that one I can't say I've experienced, but...
That's that girl's life now.
Do you get pre-nap boners?
I don't get pre-nap. I've farted out my balls before. Though. That's fun. That's the best. Have you ever done that?
What are you doing?
You so like if you're sitting like this and like they can't escape out your ass because it's like trapped by the seat and your legs are closed, the fart bubbles up out your balls basically.
Oh yeah,
yeah. It's awesome. Yeah.
Well, the reason why we're
I'm gonna need an app.
We were talking about, and it's a video I know you have seen. The guy who puts him in and
oh, shoots him out of his ass. It's so cool. Dude. It's so
majestic.
Awesome.
They, like,
dude,
like,
in this slow mo too.
And
it's like. Bloop, bloop.
Do you want to see this?
Would dude,
you
show please. Oh my god.
It's a guy.
Ketchak's got it as a photo.
I'm gonna
have to see it now. Kevin has shown it.
You have to say whether or not you want to see this though. We're not gonna just
it might be considered harassment.
This guy, it's first of all, he's very well groomed and he's in shape, so as far as, you know, you usually don't want to see that.
You can see someone fart out their own balls. This is the guy to do.
I want them to be pretty. I want them to be pretty. Like, oh, and these balls are long, and they're
what
in.
What are you just farting them out?
Puts them in.
Wait, just wait till you see.
And then he puts his leg out on
here,
his
live show? Press play.
Wait, hang on, I'm going to film.
Okay, you got to get this. It's one of the funniest. Okay,
that's smart, you hit play.
Oh, wait. Uh-oh. I feel like my grandma touching me.
Okay, ready?
Yeah, press play for me.
Let's see.
All right.
Oh, my God.
Play, please.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
It's so majestic. It's incredible.
Like,
they're
up his butt.
They're up his asshole.
Yeah.
It's the exact same response I had.
Wow.
It's amazing.
And by the way,
I'm impressed.
I guess depending on your asshole, that's hard.
It's a party trip.
Yeah. It was nicely groomed, I have to
yeah.
say. It
okay.
Dude,
like,
not a hair on that boy.
Not
a single, not even a stub, dude. It's like he waxed his nuts.
No, that's ingrown hair.
So yeah. I was at Sugared and Bronze recently, and you know, Sugared and Bronze, like, used to only sugar women.
Yes.
They said that
waxing.
Yeah. So now that he said that a lot of men are coming in just asking for the butt strip, and I was like straight men, they're like, yes, they don't want anything else waxed. They just want their asshole waxed.
Well,
and I was
everybody's like, getting the butt.
Right. I was like, they're bettering themselves for their straight women. That's great.
I also think it's one of those, like, if you're into that or trying to get into that or curious about it, I think a lot of girls are probably like, I'm not doing that until you fucking take a weed whacker back there. You know what I mean? Some guys, it's a forest back there.
Wow, that was interesting.
Wow, that was interesting.
Very offensive, considering it's an offensive thing.
Definitely.
But I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it have been much more offensive if he was, like, hairy, though?
It was just nicely made.
And he just, like, you know, he's just like, it's not like
he's very smooth.
He was as
like a ballet.
If you're gonna shit out your own balls, that's as classy as he is the ballerina of nut farts.
What does he do? His nuts too? He comes out and a bounce.
Yeah,
to it,
the bounce. Oh, we focused on the bounce yesterday. Yeah.
The bounce after that's like, you know, you do the bungee jump, but then there's that second bounce again.
Exactly.
Like, Ebony kept going.
Ebony just walked by. I want Ebony to see that video. So.
Ebony's done that to
do. She literally just walked by. I was like, God, I wish.
I mean, that's everybody knows it, but I don't think you realize just how sensitive they really are. The idea of, like, pushing them into a hole.
Damn.
Like someone else does it.
Like
before.
A magician hiding his fucking empty long rope.
Yeah, I honestly never heard of that being a thing.
I don't think it. I think he. I mean, whenever. That's the video. If you're talking about, like, shitting at your own balls, there's one guy. He is the king of that.
I mean, they showed me that live on radio one time, so it was the same.
Wow. You think that guy, like, has a crew of friends who are, like, you know, every time they get a couple in them at the party, he's like, shit your balls,
shit
your balls. Do the thing, Kendra, do the thing.
I wish I could do that.
No, you should make an OnlyFans and just do, like, weird shit.
I mean, because if he can do that, he also, they're long, He's throwing it on your shoulder. Continental Soldier, man. He has a lot going on with that.
There's a good Reddit from that called the Self Fuck Reddit.
Self-fuck.
And it's amazing. It's just guys fucking themselves, literally.
With the dicks?
And it's just all the comments.
Wait,
what? It's r/self-fuck.
They
put it underneath and fuck their own asshole.
While they're
hard. With their own dicks?
While they're hard with their own dicks.
How
and
does that work?
All the comments are amazing. Because it's just people being like, oh, good job, dude. Like, you did it. Like, it's amazing. They're all so supportive of each other.
I don't know how that works.
Can you...
I've always known that you were the guy to find the deep dark things in the web.
Because you find
but I don't know how do you even stumble onto r/self-fuck?
Incredible series of events.
But like
literally,
physics doesn't
I feel like
I've had
a boner
before.
Back.
And I just it wouldn't
I've
work.
Seen those
but like back and around,
get his dick sucked from the back.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, but like,
jeez, you guys leave me hanging there.
Yeah,
for
no. Sorry,
But it's the back, but then it's got to go up. You know what I mean?
It's got to be like the size penis from the show Sex Life.
Yeah,
that thing.
But even that,
I
feel like that's harder. Because once it gets hard, how does that get? I wasn't asking for another one of these. I thought for a beer.
Well, I don't.
I was like, damn, you're really.
Oh, there's the video right there.
There's one.
I see it.
And then, the comments are just like, dude, you did it. Good job.
So,
like,
I'll tell you what's going on here. This dude's asshole is just way too close to, like,
it's like very, it's a very high-pointed asshole.
His asshole's not in the back at all.
Yeah.
His asshole's in the front. This dude's got an asshole where, like,
but that's not just one guy.
Also, like,
all
I
these people
think,
do it.
Yeah, I mean, that's...
That looks like a woman.
Yeah, I don't think that's yeah. a. I don't. I'm not gonna give that a hard dick. That's like he might be chubbed a little bit. Yeah,
there's more. There's more. There's I looked at the most PG one I could find.
The main point is how supportive the community is, and that's really nice.
Okay, this is a better one.
That's really
this
nice.
Is a great. This is a great view right here. You can see it.
Oh my god.
Dude, this is so impressive. And again, all the comments are so assholes, supportive.
I feel like his asshole should be there when it's there.
It is a very low asshole.
A low asshole.
Yeah. What? This is bananas.
Bring that over here.
These guys' assholes are way too high.
Dude, they're amazing, though.
They're way too high.
Is like funny.
You're saying this like crazy. What the fuck? Wait,
on a scientific level, it's like fascinating.
He's on his back, legs over his head.
He's like getting his ass taken.
And
like
he was
Chuck
able
Barrett.
To take a photo. Like,
he's like fucking himself his right. ass.
I
don't
dare.
It doesn't even look like a.
This is a catastrophe.
Right, like I'd actually like to see the
this
video of how it happened.
You have the videos on there.
Okay.
Kevin, I'm sure
Ken Jack has spent some fucking time.
Don't you think that
the videos are actually
crazy?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
It's almost like a pussy in a man.
Yes.
This might be. These yes. guys, these might be people with pussies.
I get what he's saying.
I think this guy's fucking his pussy, not his asshole. Because look at this.
No, I get what he's saying.
Oh my god.
This rules for you guys. You can't film any of this.
That was too much hair on it for me.
What would you do?
We finally got
there. I like how it was like one stray hair was my
gross. Come on now.
Poor Revitalite.
I know, I mean.
None of this could be shown on the camera. It's all censored out.
It's not even a drinking Friday night
plan. No, this is just, again, this is a catastrophe. If you were dating a guy,
oh my god.
Dream life. Dream
this
guy.
This is not normally
great
what
life.
Happens. I want you to know. Well, this is not normally what happens.
It's
never seen a dick
not.
In someone's own ass.
Yeah, it's well, I just didn't go so far to call
I've
it
seen
abnormal.
Some weird shit.
Yeah. This is extreme, but not.
Yeah, no, it's not crazy.
So you got a guy. He's perfect.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like, dream guy. And, you know, let's say 6 months in or whatever after, he's like, I got a kink. I fuck my own ass. And I want you to like do it for me and like yeah, put it
tuck
in.
Tuck it in for me.
Yeah.
Do it for me.
Yeah. Tuck me in tonight.
I need you to tuck me in tonight.
She's like, sure. And he's like, no. Oh, no.
I will say this.
Common mistake.
Hot guys get away with a lot more. Like, let's say you're a hot guy in a bar
too.
And you say this cheesy pickup line to me. I'm like, that's fucking hot.
Yeah.
And then if the same like weirdo says it, I'm like,
you're
just loser.
That's
yeah.
the infamous
Tom Brady skit.
Tom
yeah.
Brady skit on SNL.
Yes.
Went way back when that would never fly now. He's like sexually harassing the girls in the skit and he's okay because he's hot and the other guys do it and they're
right.
like, you're going to jail.
Yeah.
So
let's
if Tom Brady wants to fuck his own
ass. 50 Shades of Grey is like that. Like if that was like
yes.
an ugly
yes.
poor dude, like that's just straight
you're
up
going to
jail.
So
yeah. Like you're
yeah.
just getting put in prison.
So I think I was like,
a poor guy.
I know. I said you had to throw a poor in there.
Yeah, because he's super rich. Like he could be an ugly billionaire and she probably still would have done it.
Yeah. No,
I'm
pretty sure
most billionaires are not overly
no,
attractive
I don't
either.
Think she
yeah, that's
I don't
true.
Know if there's any who are hot. Who are hot?
If he was still really. Well, yeah, but it also helps that he's just like super rich.
So
I only know like
someone for 6 months. And it's not that many.
I just
think
about 6 months. I don't know. You know, after,
I think
after you,
I mean,
yeah.
if they're
so
your
you've
dream
been having
person,
some sex,
then
and, like,
yeah.
and he's like, you know, sex life is good, but
you got it.
You know, and this is one thing I've been really like yearning for, and you're like,
if
okay,
it's your dream
what is
person,
it, babe?
Yeah,
but I
think
also that violates the rules of r/self-fuck.
Mm-hmm.
It's not self-fuck.
Oh, true.
If you're getting tucked in, yeah.
Imagine that if he did it. Imagine if she tucks him in, he's like, you know, just didn't do it for me. It's
got
to be by myself. I got
it.
You know.
Yeah, what'd you do? If, like you guys, like he's like, oh, I want to do it tonight, and you're like, oh, I'm not into it. Can you just like jerk off or something? And he just puts his legs up and he's like, all right, and just tucks himself in.
No.
Yeah.
It'd be shocking.
What about if you walk in on your boyfriend
in the long run.
And he's sucking your own dick? He's sucking his own dick. You walk in on him.
No.
What?
Because then that means he's missing some ribs or something. Like something's too
what
flexible.
What if he's just flexible and in shape, and you walk
like
in on
yoga.
Him, and he's like, I mean, I'm doing it. Like I do it behind closed doors. I don't do it with you because I know.
Honestly,
he's just trying to do his own thing. You would dump your dream guy just because he has strange masturbatory habits?
I don't think you can call that masturbatory.
Yeah, that's not. That's
just strange.
I think you can.
Masturbatory,
is it like hand exclusive?
Yeah. I think it's self-pleasure.
Plus, I feel like
right?
it is.
Plus, do you know
if
I really don't know how I
react
in these
situations?
Like,
I mean, it really depends.
Oh,
No.
That's why I was taking it to the extreme. Like, what is it then?
It
says erotic stimulation of one's own genitals. Commonly resulting in an orgasm achieved by manual or other body contact.
Yeah, you can suck your own dick.
Okay. No, but if
yeah,
you,
not,
so you're
right.
Gonna dump your man because of masturbation, technically.
If he swallow, if you swallow your own nut, your nut technically never left your body, and you didn't masturbate at all.
That's like closed loops.
It never broke air. Closed loop.
That was a closed loop. That was in succession. That's what he.
Yeah.
He got blown, and then he kissed it, and then he kissed the girl, and she spit it back into his mouth.
Yeah.
It's like it's closed loop. I didn't cheat.
Exactly. Yeah.
Tom. Poor Tom.
If you, that would be a deal breaker.
I think it would be.
Where do you draw the line?
I think I would be.
He's not sucking his own dick. Maybe he's jerking it off, and he's putting a finger in his own ass.
I think that wouldn't bother me. That's more normal. Guys can't suck their own dicks.
What about you walk in and he's
Wait, but wouldn't that be a dream for every guy to be able to do that?
No. So it's funny you say that. I just had
But you think if it was part of the culture already, it would just be like another thing.
Think about it. I mean, I know it's different and more extreme, but if you're to look at jerking off, and it's like, if I were to lube you up, Trent, and I'm jerking you off until you come, you know, that's gay. That's crazy. If you're doing that exact same thing yourself, it's fine. So what's the difference, you know?
Yeah, you're so not like, as
it's technically...
He's like, tie me up!
We have an ATI question.
Take my ribs out now!
We have an ATI question, that is, if you could suck your own dick, would you? And also, you know, if everyone knew that that was the case, would you still do it? And I think if everyone's being honest with themselves, they would, and they would probably say no if people knew.
But then,
Mark Normand on the show, very funny comic. His ATI is not out yet, but spoiler alert, that question is out there. And he said he achieved a lick. He was able to lick. Flexible guy, in shape, he got a lick in. And he said afterwards that he was like, what the fuck am I doing?
It's just like a shame.
You think that you would be like, oh, yes, now I can get blowjobs whenever I want. But when you're doing it to yourself, you're like, oh, no.
Yeah, the second you taste your own pre-cum, then
it'll
be like, what is happening here?
Maybe, Mark, but I...
You'd probably give it a college try. You try.
I think you're lying if you say you wouldn't give it a try. And I think you're lying if you gave it a try and you were able to, you would do it to completion.
I agree with him.
I think the second you got a dick in your mouth, you start.
I would have to be the
I'm not saying you would just, it would be like easy peasy, like it's crazy. I think there's some shit going through your mind, but I think you'd be like, well, I got to finish.
It also just wouldn't be comfortable to be like folded in half like that for a long time.
Yeah, that's so
true. I imagine it's hard enough to breathe with a dick in your mouth without having your respiratory system
folded upside down. I cannot even imagine.
Like, you talk about mascara like running down girls' faces, and
you imagine if you're like, all right, you're trying to give yourself head, but then you're like, like you're giving yourself head.
You go to look in the mirror to be like, just like think about your life. And you're crying.
You're a mess.
You're like, I made myself cry, sucking my own dick.
You put the mascara on first so that you get the run.
Kevin's gonna dress up. He's gonna have like a little dress on and sundress.
Put some red lipstick on.
How about that? What if you walk in on your boyfriend and he's dressed like he's cross dressing? You draw the line there?
Look, none of this is for me.
What about
Kevin's testing a lot of waters right here?
None of it.
Like, what about reverse? What if you ran into your girl and she's going down on herself?
We're talking about different things.
Yeah,
don't care.
I would be like, okay. I'd be like, all right, let me talk. Hang on. I've been waiting for this. I saw a porn once. I'll see if I can find it. I think there was several. How would one
another
video
that won't be able to make fun of this?
How would one?
What an episode!
Boy, you know the trending searches sometimes Russian homemade. Who's like, I need the Russian.
The trending searches
right
on Pornhub are a fucking nightmare.
Pepper Heart. I love her.
Pepper Heart. Don't worry.
What does that mean?
Pepper Heart. It's just a porn site.
Oh, it's a name. Okay. Like, this is the trend. So there's Kenzie Madison, Emily Willis, Mariah Mills. So, okay, people searching for names. Then there's Russian homemade.
Don't want that.
Stockings, cum mouth, pepper heart, sissy crossdress, and then there's just butt. Imagine, like, I'm all alone. I get the lotion out. What do I want?
When you see things like cum mouth, you realize how many like 13-year-olds are getting onto Pornhub.
Just, they yeah, just
it's just like cum
there.
Mouth yeah. butt. Yeah. Yeah.
I remember when I first we went down to my buddy's basement, jumped on his dad's computer on like a PC. He was showing me, you know, freeones.com, whatever it was.
Oh no.
And I saw the pop-up ads basically saying like, come see me, and they spelled it like come, and I thought it was the funniest thing in the whole world. I was like, yeah, another come. It's the real
thing. Dude, on free ones, there was always this section with like the top video of the day, random video of the day for like 8 major categories. It would be like blowjob video, anal video, whatever, all it. And then the last one was balloon popping. And I was always like, what the fuck is that? And then one time I opened it, and it was just a naked girl sitting on balloons and popping.
For the major categories?
Yeah, I remember that.
Some for everybody.
That balloon friction thing. Yeah. Do you guys remember that video went around?
Yeah, with the cat.
What?
What?
Like something with balloons and friction. What was that?
Oh, I thought you said crushing.
No. Oh, okay. That's super upsetting.
Crushing is fucked
that's
up.
I think it's worse than like cake farts and all
that. I don't
know. You've seen cake farts.
These Japanese girls put on like high heels and just step on like kittens.
What?
Yeah. Sometimes they put like a glass table on it, and then it's called something like crushing, right?
It's not a sexual thing. It's just
people find it sexual, lingerie, and like it is a sexual.
But they are just smushing or whatever that is. You remember when that was pretty viral a couple of years ago? They would like smash their face into bread.
Oh yeah.
That's much better than stabbing cats with stilettos. Jesus Christ!
I can't seem to find this, but the video I saw was a girl. It was supposed to be like she had her legs over her head. But she was very clearly sitting on the stomach of a girl
who was
laying down, and they just threw like a blanket over her. So her leg, it's like when you do that thing where you put your arms around someone
else.
But if I saw that, that wouldn't fucking faze me one bit.
No.
You guys say that, but you'd be weirded out.
Listen, let me tell you something. I assure you I wouldn't be.
I'll
be very impressed.
I'll put every penny to my name on the bet right now. That I would not be weirded out at all. And if anyone wants to try and call me on it, we can fucking do it.
But there's such a double standard.
Yeah, because you guys are judgmental pricks.
No.
Right? We're all socially open to it.
No, but you guys all say you don't want to do it to yourself. So you're
judging yourself. You must have misheard me, girl.
John said he
you're
did
down
want
to try.
Yeah.
I said I would try, and I did not expect I would like it.
Plus, it's the bad angle for a blowjob, too. It's like the 69 angle for yourself. Agreed. I don't like that. I'm not saying
it's going to be the best.
Your nuts are going to be doing a fucking damage. You're gonna come out with 2 black eyes from your nuts.
That's a good point.
But I feel like, it's obviously different. I understand. But if you were to tell me, like, your hands are going to be covered in cum, you'd be like, oh, that's fucking gross. When you're jerking off, that can happen, and you're like, whatever. You know?
Why is he talking about blasting off on his own belly?
I do a lot of fucking...
You fill up your belly button, man. It's like,
yeah, but swallowing your cum versus having it on your stomach is wildly different.
But you don't have to swallow it. But again, it's like we don't even think about the fact that you're blasting cum on your own belly.
True.
So if you were able to do that, you would just... Would you just take your mouth off and just see where it goes?
You're
folded in half.
Would you finish in your own mouth?
No, I think you don't.
Bro, have you ever seen me on this goddamn show here? I think I'd do with a nut in my mouth.
It's your own nut.
It's the same texture as any other nut.
He's worried about the texture.
So if
cum was like chocolate milk, you'd be okay with it?
I suppose, yeah.
So your problem is not the sexual nature; it's the physical, physical nature.
It's the texture of it, the runny egg of it is.
That's why I can't
cook egg whites, because when I'm cooking egg whites, I'm just like, oh, as they're starting to cook, I'm like, this is disgusting.
Looks like cum. I'm about to close
it. I don't know what the texture is in your mouth, but in the pan, it doesn't look good.
I feel like
that comparison gives me the chills.
That's not a fair comparison. Egg whites are way
depends how they're cooked.
What people say coconut water. They say looks wise, conditioner is usually pretty bang on.
Yeah, that's way thicker though.
I guess it depends on, you know, what you're shooting.
Right. Depends on your diet.
Yeah. Depends on how much water you had that day.
Am I dehydrated? Yeah. You know, when's the last time I blasted off?
Is it a creamier load if you're...
That was so casual.
What is happening?
Like at the doctor's office, you're filling out, like, the clipboards. Like, on a scale of, like, you know, smiley face to frowny face. Is it a creamy load?
I read a
you're talking to your doctor. It's like an Alfredo sauce. It's like a...
I think if you're super dehydrated, you gotta like pull it out.
Icing in one of those.
It's just string.
It's like hard.
I read that once. I drink a lot of water, so I've never had to deal with it. But you see how much water I drink. You think I dehydrate? Come on.
You gotta have better hydration. This is a disgraceful episode. This is great. I love it.
I forgot the cameras were there, which is always.
That does tend to happen.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, like, when do I have to stop this? One time we were interviewing Anthony Mackie.
Yeah.
His name? And, Marvel. Flying bird guy was
Falcon.
Bird guy.
We got there.
Dude, I love the way Dragonfly Jones was talking about it. He called it, what'd he say? He said, I'm not going to lie, I only watched 2 episodes of N-Word Bird and the guy with the bionic arm. Like, that's how he just summed it up. He said to me, like, he's like, you know, y'all are having like all this fun right now. I think we had just asked him, like, something about his butt or Chris Evans' butt. We were a tame version of this, but we were being aggressive. And he was like, you know, y'all guys, like, you're having all your fun now, but, like, you know, your kids, talking to me, he's like, they're going to get a little older soon, and you're going to have to, like, cut all that out. And I was like, oh, word? No. Do I? And if so, when do I? But I guess I kind of do at some point.
What do you mean?
Like, I got to, like, you know, like, when my kids are, like, of age to understand this shit, I got to, like,
they shouldn't be
I think all of us are already pretty far down that path. I think it might be too late.
Way too late. Here's the thing. People say that all the time about me, and it's like, you think that Shay is going to go dig up a fucking podcast from how long ago? Like, by the time she's not even going to listen to podcasts. You know?
Right.
Also, no, it's like,
and like, does she think you're a priest? No.
Right.
But,
if
you stopped doing it, then like her friends wouldn't be talking about it either. That's how she would end up hearing about it, is if you were still doing it, like her guy friends were like, you hear what your dad said? He wants to fuck his own asshole.
Wait, you said that during this? I missed that part.
You know what, Kevin? I think we just go full steam ahead.
That's why I gotta make sure we're like really rich. I gotta be like, it's like that skit, Shane Gillis did a skit about...
But listen, these are the conversations people have with their friends. Like, it is what it is. We just have cameras.
Yes, their friends, not with their dad.
Yeah.
They usually don't have to be like...
Well, hopefully those little kids are going to grow up to be like, so... I don't know. Hopefully, I feel like little kids like, don't care. Yeah,
they'll be like,
that old thing.
We all fuck our own asses. About how much of a prude Mr. Clancy is? You know.
What was the Shane Gillis thing?
He did a skit. Gillian Keeves is right up there with I Think You Should Leave as far as skit stuff goes. And he did a skit about OnlyFans' dad. And it was like the father... And Shane does this great, like, suburban dad. He's got a polo on and his glasses, and he's riding a Sibian. You know, it was like...
Yeah.
Which, by the way, if I was a girl, I would invest in that.
Which also,
those
like,
$2,000 and probably worth every fucking penny.
They really went out of style. I remember back in the day when
Stern
I started
show
watching
was
porn,
like
Stern
place,
Show,
yeah.
It's like Sibians all over.
But
I haven't seen a Sibian in a porn in a long time.
Not in a porn. I saw... there's a romantic
what's
depot.
A Sibian? It's like a horse saddle, except it jerks you off. Not for men, for girls.
It's a vibrator. You know?
No.
I'm surprised by that.
It's a saddle?
I said a saddle.
It's kind of a saddle.
It's like a mechanical bull. Imagine a mechanical bull,
but
no...
You're describing a saddle.
Yes. You're right, but...
And it just vibrates.
And it's got a dick on
there's
it,
a, There's a dick on it, but it's got like a knob,
but
and it's like...
But people have these in their
rooms. You turn it up. Well, that's the thing, is like... It's pretty big, and it's like...
Where do you keep that? You have like a room for it?
Yeah, you need to have a red room.
Listen, if I was a chick, I would find a fucking way.
What was the big thing? Had Carmen Electra do it or something on Stern Show?
Yeah, like you would have girls come in and sit down and then do the interview.
Not with like the dick thing in, but like just the more vibration.
Oh, they would have... I thought they had the dick thing in.
I didn't think there was penetration.
Now?
Young girl to your office, hey, come sit on this thing.
Yeah, it sucks because we wouldn't be doing that, right? But Shane is riding it as a dad.
Yeah.
And they're like, why isn't dad at the dinner table? And he's like, I'm gonna go find him. And the mom's like, no, do not go in there. And he's riding, and he's like, and at one point he goes, this thing really sneaks up on you. But you hear the bells going off, like the tips. And he looks in, he's like, African Rose. Thank you, African Rose. But I don't even know why.
This is a devastating episode.
I don't know how we got here.
Our stuff on the internet.
This is why. Because he was like, do you like going to the lake house? Do you like having that boat? The reason why we have the jet skis, goddamn.
Oh, right. You said we gotta be rich.
We gotta be rich to make it all worth it, because Lord knows it's super embarrassing otherwise. So, yeah, man. I think we gotta call it. This episode's out of control.
All right. I got okay.
Welcome to Primary Pints.
Alyssa.
And you've got a great tan.
Thank you.
Yes, you do.
And you got a nice butt, and it's real.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Kevin.
Thank you for the weird material. Mm-hmm. And as always, babe.
Yeah. Oh, bad one. Again.
Yeah. Kevin, you also have a nice ass, and it's real.
Hey! Is it? Maybe I got the BBL. You never know. Go get Drink Revitalite. Go to drinkrevitalite.com. Go to the Barstool Sports store. Get that black label. We'll see you guys next week for hopefully maybe a more... Fuck it. Crazier edition of Friday Night Pints.
Thanks for watching Friday Night Pints. Make sure you click on the bell icon below to keep up with notifications, and make sure you subscribe to our channel. Strong drinks, full pints. Can't lose.
Can't lose.